If you get a copy of the Bible kindly, keep John chapter 14 open.
Let not your heart be troubled.
Let not your heart be troubled. Neither let it be afraid. This is the Lord's message to you this morning. The Lord is sending a prophetic message to you. Many of us are familiar with this promise. This verse, let not your heart be troubled. And I could imagine, I could see that this would adorn, this would beautify the walls of many houses. It's one of the beautiful wall texts. Let not your heart be troubled. But I do believe very few know the background in which Jesus said, let not your heart be troubled. It was in the evening that he was betrayed. He was with his disciples in the upper room, participating not only in the Passover, participating his Last Supper. A Last Supper. Just imagine, you know that you are going to die. You are sitting with your family, and you know this is the Last Supper you are going to have with your children, with your dear husband. The Last Supper as a family are sitting together. And you have told your husband, you have told your children, you have told your wife, you have told your children. Or you told your parents, Mom, Dad, this is the Last Supper I'm going to have with you. Or the daddy tells the members of the family, darling, my lovely children, this is the Last Supper we are going to have together. How much it will break the hearts of the people. It is a highly electrified situation. The human propensities are shattered. This is the Last Supper we are going to have together. It is not that my son is going to America. It is not my son is going to moon on a promotion. Though the separation is painful, we could be happy about it. But here the loving Jesus says, I will be betrayed. This is the darkest hour. I will be handed over to the Gentiles. You all will be scattered. One will betray me. One will deny me. Master, is it I? The hearts are broken. And he said, I will be scourged. I will be sentenced for crucifixion. Jesus, is that true? Should this happen to you? No, it should not happen to you. Disciples' hearts were broken. Yes, it will happen. I will be crucified. Darkness shrouded them. What is our future? We left our boat. We left our nets. We started following this Jesus. Now they are hundreds of miles away from their hometown. They all were mostly from Galilee. Now they are in Jerusalem. How will they go back to Galilee without Jesus? They are very proud. They are followers of Jesus. They are disciples of Jesus. They are there. Members of the core group, inner circle, the immediate assistants of Jesus, the lieutenants of Jesus. How will they go back home without Jesus? If they tell people Jesus is crucified, is there any future for these people? They have to go back for fishing. Others will mock at them. The other fishermen will laugh at them. What you people said, Jesus, Jesus, 3 years you gave up your business and you went behind this fellow, this carpenter's son. What happened? Didn't we tell you earlier he is a cheat? Didn't we tell you earlier all these things will not work out? Didn't we tell you earlier that our synagogue leaders, they all are against this fellow? He went after this guy. What happened? How are we going to answer this question? Literally, spiritually, eternally, the darkest hour. The gloom was hanging over them. They didn't know who was going to betray Jesus. Peter could not really take it in when Jesus said that you would deny me at least thrice before the cock could crow. No, Lord, that should not happen. In that situation, Jesus said, let not your heart be troubled. Why did Jesus say, let not your hearts be troubled? Because their hearts are troubled. Their hearts are troubled. Dear sister, dear brother, you are looking unto Jesus. I do believe that every one of you in these days, with fasting and praying, seeking the Lord, the Spirit of the Lord sends me with His word of promise, let not your heart be troubled. 100 people can come and tell us, let not your heart be troubled. Let not your heart be troubled. Nobody can wipe away our tears. One day, at the gate of the Nain, Jesus saw that widow, the mother of the young boy, the lad who died and taken for burial. She was running behind the bed. In those days, women will not go to the sepulchre. This young widow who lost her only son, why was she running behind the bed of her son? Probably she would have cried like this. There is no hope for me. There is no life for me. There is no purpose for me. There is no light for me. Why should I live anymore? I lost my husband. Now I lost my son. For what purpose I should live anymore? The people are saying she is a cursed lady. She swallowed up her husband. Probably she lived for this little boy. Now this little boy also died. There is no life for her. Probably she would have desired, let me die with this boy. Let me also be buried with him. All hopes are lost. She was running behind the bed. It was at the gate of city of Nain. A great multitude was going with her. They are with no hope. They are with no light. They are with no life. This funeral procession was going without the city. When this funeral procession was going without the city, another procession was coming within the city. It was a beautiful, a very dramatic, a volatile situation. One procession was going out. Another procession was coming in. It was at the gate of city of Nain. People without hope and the star of hope. People in darkness and he that is light. With a dead body, he that is life and resurrection. Death and life. Darkness and light. Hopelessness and lively hope. They meet at the city, at the gate of the city of Nain. Jesus looked at that woman, moved with compassion came nearer to her and said, "Weep not. Don't weep." She was weeping. "Don't weep. Weep not. Don't weep." She was weeping. "Don't weep. Don't weep. Don't weep. Don't weep." But she was still weeping. She was still weeping. Nobody could turn her tears into rejoicing. Nobody could turn her bitterness into sweet. I always remember that story like this. I love to imagine. I love to see it as a dramatic field. I imagine like this. She was from a nearby village. She was given in marriage to a man, a young man in Nain. The day came, she was to leave her house to go to Nain. She was moved to tears, leaving her loving parents, her family, going to another village, to a family she knew not. I don't know what type of man he would be, what type of parents-in-law they would be, what type of a mother-in-law she would get. She didn't know anything. Young girl, she was moved to tears. Her father came closer to her, wiped the tears from her cheek, and told her, "My daughter, don't weep. Don't weep. We are with you. Your brothers are here. We have got some of our relatives in Nain. Your husband is a good man. We'll also come and see you off, and you can also come here. Don't weep, my child." That father is not here now to wipe away her tears. One day when her husband was coming back home, she was in tears. He said, "What happened?" He loved her very much. "What happened?" "Your mother said this, said this, said this." He just pulled her by the left hand, hugged her. With his right hand, he wiped away her tears and said, "Ah, don't weep, honey. I am with you. Everything is a passing cloud. I'll talk to mommy. Mommy will understand. We all love you. Okay, don't worry." He wiped away her tears. He is not there. The whole world is lost for her. But she's left with his son in her hand. She decided, I love to live for our son. He saw her husband in her son. She lived for him. One day some problem, she was in tears. The little boy, the toddler, came nearer to mommy. Said, "Mommy, mommy, don't weep, mommy. Don't weep, mommy." With his little hand, he wiped away her tears. She smiled, took that boy, hugged him. She said, "No, son, I won't weep. I won't weep." The boy became a young man. The boy said, "Mommy, you shall weep no more. I know how much you suffered to bring me up. I am your comfort, mommy. I'll make sure that you'll be like a queen. How much you suffered to bring me up. I will work hard. I'll buy good dress for you. No more we are in starvation. All the days of your tears are over, mommy. Weep not." That son is not there. That father is not there. That husband is not there. That son is not there. Many people came. She was weeping and weeping and weeping. Hundreds of people came and told her, "Weep not, weep not, weep not. Who can stop her weeping?" They all may say, "Weep not." But nobody can change her weeping. Nobody can change her weeping. She was running behind the prayer. at the gate of the city of Nain, one man came and he said, weep not. He said, weep not. It made a much difference. The Bible says she went back home rejoicing. When he says, weep not, he can change your tears into rejoicing. We could ask that lady, which is the greatest day in your life? What is a joyful day in your life? Is that your birthday? No. Is that your wedding day? No. Is it the day that somebody came and told you that you have got a boy child? No, that is a day. The greatest day, a day greater than all these things. What is that day? The greatest day in your life. The day when Jesus met me at the gate of the city of Nain. Jesus says, let not your heart be troubled. 100 people can say, let not your heart be troubled. Nobody can do anything. It's a prophetic word to somebody. It's a prophetic word to somebody. Even then I knew it was a prophetic message to somebody. Let not your heart be troubled. Neither be afraid. What will happen to my future? What is next? What is next? I'm left alone in my family. There's no one that can understand me. My children don't understand me. I'm alone. What will happen to my future? And I'm very alone, he told me. I'm not scared, I'm not afraid. But when I go to bed, I feel very lonely. There will be nobody with me when I die. It's not necessary that somebody should be with me when I die. Everybody will die alone. But I don't know how I would see the Spirit of the Lord is speaking to you. Loneliness is eating you up. You're afraid to see tomorrow. Maybe because of your financial constraints. What is next? My dear brother, my dear sister, if you read that whole chapter, Jesus gives a lot of promises why they need not be afraid. Just I share with you, as the time permits, a few things. We shall go straight to verse 21. That's a very powerful verse in that chapter. All these things Jesus was speaking to his disciples in that upper room. Let not your heart be troubled, neither be afraid. You know why? We read in verse 21,
he that hath my commandments and keepeth them, he it is that loveth me, and he that loveth me shall be loved of my Father, and I will love him and will manifest myself to him.
Jesus says, I will love him and I will manifest myself to him. Your master will not be hid from your eyes. Because I say I go away, let not your heart be troubled. Neither be afraid. I will love you in all your critical juncture. I will manifest myself to you. I will reveal my power to you. I will reveal my compassion to you. I will not leave you. I will manifest myself to you. Let not your heart be troubled. Because I am going away. Because I am going away. Let not your heart be troubled. I will manifest myself to you. Disciples could understand that in a greater way. One day, Jesus performed one of the greatest miracles. with 5 loaves of bread and 2 fishes, they were able to feed a multitude, maybe the size of 10,000 people. They have seen that miracle. And at the end of the miracle, Jesus constrained them. Jesus constrained to go over to the other side of the Galilean Sea. So disciples departed. Jesus retreated himself into the mountain for prayer. The hearts of the disciples were excited. So they were rowing the ship. Probably Peter was saying, just I had a few loaves of bread. Every time I was giving to somebody and I could see the loaves of bread still remaining on my platter, on the basket. John said, yes, yes. He told me to serve the fishes. I'm just giving fish to somebody, but still I could see fish in my basket. Who is this man? With whom we are? With whom are we? They are excited. Now in the midnight, they come to the mid-sea. A great storm broke out. A great storm broke out. They toil their best. Their mood pushed to their worst. They could neither go forward nor could come back. They were caught in darkness. The sea was too rough to this seasoned fisherman. Jesus was not with them. Even there was no boat, the Bible says, there was no boat on this side for Jesus to come to them. There was no boat. Even if Jesus desired to come and help them, there was no boat here. There was nobody to help them. There was nobody to help them. They were caught up in the mid-sea. They are seeing the gates of death. They are seeing the gates of death. When they were on the threshold of eternity, they saw a ghost walking on the water. They knew it. They were able to see a ghost because they are already in the fear of death. Peter might have thought, or John might have thought, or James might have thought, a ghost is coming to take them away. A ghost is coming to take them away. They screamed. They screamed. It was a ghost. They are about to die. When they are about to die, they saw a ghost walking on the waters. They thought they are going to die. A ghost is coming to take their spirit away. They screamed. Jesus said, hey, be of good cheers. Be of good cheers. One of the 3 places where Jesus said, be of good cheers. Cheer up, man. Cheer up. It's I. It's I. Jesus loved them when they were in great toil. And Jesus manifested himself to them in that predicament. When they were in the jaws of death, Jesus manifested himself to them. Jesus was able to calm the storm. Jesus was able to make Peter also walk on the water. Jesus was able to save Peter from drowning. They could not forget that. Peter could not forget that. Now in this upper room, Jesus says, let not your heart be troubled. I will love you and I will manifest myself to you. Why should your hearts be troubled? Why should your hearts be troubled? I will love you and I will manifest myself. So let not your hearts be troubled. It is not the crucified Jesus. It's the risen Savior telling you. Whatever your situation may be, when you love Jesus, when you obey his commandments, Jesus will love you and Jesus will reveal himself to you. Jesus will manifest his power to you. Jesus will manifest his compassion to you. Jesus will manifest his love to you. He changes not. Let not your hearts be troubled. Be of good cheer. Not only that, we read John chapter 14, verses 13 and 14.
And whatsoever you shall ask in my name, that will I do, that the Father may be glorified in the Son. And if you shall ask anything in my name, I will do it.
Let not your heart be troubled. Whatsoever you ask in my name. You ask anything. Whatsoever you ask. You ask anything. We read verses 13 and 14 again, please.
And whatsoever you shall ask in my name.
Whatsoever. Is there any limit? Whatsoever. Jesus is not a liar. When Jesus said something, he didn't mean anything else. When Jesus said whatsoever, it is whatsoever. Whatsoever you ask in my name. Verse 14.
If you shall ask anything in my
name. If you shall ask anything in my name. When we ask, we can be careful. Whether we ask it for the glory of God or we ask it for ourselves. We have to be very careful what we ask. It's not that because of this blanket promise, it's not that we can ask anything and then we should not be suffering. At times when Jesus doesn't answer your prayers, apparently it's a blessing. I always remember this one instance. In that one instant, the devils asked Jesus, send us into the swines. Immediately Jesus answered even the prayers of those devils. Jesus granted the request of those evil spirits. All those spirits went to the swine and got drowned in the sea. That the man possessed with the legion of spirit, he was delivered, he was healed. He had a sober mind, sitting at the feet of Jesus. The devils asked, send us to the swines. This man asked, give me permission to go with thee. Jesus said, no. You need not go with me. Jesus sent him as a missionary to his own. The promise is whatsoever you ask, anything you ask, he will grant it. But we have to be careful what we ask, why we ask. But one thing we can have great confidence in our life. What a friend we have in Jesus to answer all our prayers. What peace we often forfeit. What peace we often forfeit because we don't take everything to the Lord in prayer. Because we don't take everything to the Lord in prayer. Our God knows our needs. At times when we ask, He gives. At times even when we don't ask, He gives. He loves to meet all our needs. When we being evil, when we know to give good things to our children, how much it's more certain that He will give good things to them that ask Him. Seek ye first the kingdom of God and its righteousness. All these things shall be added unto you. All these things shall be added unto you. Whatsoever you ask, whatsoever you need may be, whatsoever you need may be, the Lord will grant that to you. Whatsoever you ask, whatsoever you need, He will grant that to you. Let not your heart be troubled. Why should your heart be troubled? Why should your heart be troubled? Verse 16 says,
and I will pray the Father, and He shall give you another comforter.
He shall give you another comforter.
That He may abide with you forever.
It is not that I am leaving you. I'm not leaving you comfortless. I'll give you another comforter. He will be with you. He will abide with you. He spoke about the Holy Spirit. will not leave you. He will abide with you. He will strengthen you. The presence of Holy Spirit in all our situation, it is the greatest joy. When we walk through the waters, when we cross the fire, in our mountaintops, when we are at the bottom of the valleys, He will never leave us. He will never leave us. Even when everybody leaves us, He will not leave us. There is a relative for me. Always with me. Wherever I go, he would go with me. There was no other travel companion to me as he was. Helping me in every possible way. I loved him. I can't say that I loved any other person as I loved him. I got a lot of friends. But this was more than a friendship, a decade. For no reason. Till I could understand, till this day I could understand. He left me. He left me in love. Many people, dearly beloved, left us in love. Our pastor Sundaram passed away. My mother passed away. The day my father died, I was fully composed to take care of every funeral arrangement. And I came back home. And the whole thing was over. When I was alone, I was shattered. There is nobody above me. No mother. No father. No pastor. For me, no mother. No father. No pastor. Nobody above me. Jesus gives you a comforter who will never leave you alone. Never he leaves you alone. Today, sister and I will not be able to do this ministry unless or otherwise the comforter has sustained us. The comforter has sustained us. It's our personal testimony. Let not your heart be troubled. Last 2 days, the Lord is giving a powerful message. In the path of Paul's ministry, the Lord permitted jail. He didn't stop his ministry. He was doing his ministry. In the life of Paul, yesterday there was a powerful message which I never meditated. What was happening in the small little island, Melita? In the small little island, Melita. It was God's plan. It was God's plan that Paul should go to Melita. Even before that, God told Paul, we have to fall into a small island. The ship will fall in a small island. We will meet a shipwreck in a small island. It was not accidental. It was not accidental. It was God's plan. There Paul was able to do ministry. That Paul was to heal many people. It was God's plan. It was the plan of everybody to go to Rome. En route Rome, it was God's plan they should go to Melita. Whether Rome or Melita. God has got a plan for you. He will not leave you. In verse 18, he says, please read.
I will not leave you comfortless.
The word here it says, I will not leave you comfortless. Literally, I will not leave you orphans. I will not leave you directionless. Thikkattavargalaga. I will not leave you unattended to. I will love you. I will reveal myself to you. I will answer your prayers. I will send a comforter who will abide you. I will not leave you orphans. I will not leave you unattended to. My dear, I will care for you. My eyes shall be upon you. I know he watches. His eyes are on the sparrow. I know he watches over me. Verse 28, he says, I give you my peace. Let not your hearts be troubled. I give you my peace. Let not your hearts be troubled. You say, there's nobody for me. I'm an orphan. Everybody is there, but I am an orphan. Nobody understands me. I don't know what direction I should take. In this morning, this is the Lord's promise to you. Sister, the Lord says, I will not leave you unattended to. My eyes shall be up. Ahuradhinama, the prophecy is coming straight to you, sister. My eyes are upon you. My eyes are upon you. I will not leave you uncared for. You know that I care for you. I will not leave you in lack. I will not leave you orphan. I will not leave you unattended to. Why should your heart be troubled in this morning? Cheer up, sister. Cheer up, brother. Be of good cheers. I don't know to whom the Lord is speaking. But I know the prophetic utterance is coming straight to somebody. I will not leave you unattended to. Yes, you said, there's nobody to care for me. I live for everybody. There was a time I lived for my parents. There was a time I lived for my family. There was a time I lived for my husband. There's a time that I'm living for my children. I'm living only for others. There's nobody to care for me. That is Uradhina Marraba. There's nobody to love me. I'm living for others. I'm living for others and I'm dying. The Lord says, my eyes are on you. Oh, hallelujah. Verse 28, he says, I give you my peace. In verse 2 he says, I will come again. And again he says, I will receive you to be with me where I shall be. Let not your heart be troubled. I will manifest myself to you. Whatsoever you ask, anything you ask, I will give that to you, that Father may be glorified. The Holy Spirit shall abide with you always. I will not leave you uncared for. I give you my peace, my child. I feel in my spirit, Jesus is putting his hand around somebody. Jesus is putting his hand around somebody, pulling you close to him. I feel it in my spirit. I'm not trying to dramatizing it. I feel what I say. Wiping away your tears. I don't know whether you are here. You are watching this online. The Lord pulls you by his side. Wipes away your tears and tells you, my child, my daughter, don't worry. Let not your heart be troubled. I love you. I will come again. I will receive you. For you to be with me where I stand to your feet. Even if you are watching it alive, feel the presence of God wherever you are. In this morning, the Lord says, don't worry. Let not your hearts be troubled. Let not their hearts be troubled. Help them believe in you. Believe also in the Father. Neither let their hearts be afraid. Jesus. Weep not. Don't weep. His eyes are on the sparrow. I know he watches over me. Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus.